Well, while NASCAR may be popular across the country, some environmentalists have reservations about the races, especially since all the cars in competition are fossil fuel guzzlers. But one race in Mexico may change all that in the near future. CCTV's Frank Contreras has more.
The Formula E Series is historic. It's the world's first championship with fully electric cars. They are designed to pollute far less than their faster Formula One cousins. Now in its second season, these races are still gaining traction among autosports fans. And this is the sound of the future, according to Formula E drivers and their technical teams.
Race promoters say we are not just seeing the future of this sport, but the future of the automobile industry.
Formula E aims to become the world's top research and development platform for electric cars. Already, race teams have developed improved technology that maintains battery temperatures under duress. Formula E CEO says globally renowned race teams are involved, and they're now developing new technologies that recharge e-car batteries when drivers apply the brakes.
These are car builders who are leaders in development. It's innovation designed to help them win championships and thus improve electric car technology.
Support for electric car racing is coming from former Formula One champions like Frenchman Alain Prost. Mexican race fans understand what's at stake.
This is a very contaminated city, so it's really good that such racers are giving a push in the right direction so that we begin to aspire to have electric cars.
The first Formula E electric car race in the Mexican capital has come to an end, but not without drama. The apparent winner, Brazilian Lucas de Grassi, is disqualified when it's determined his car did not meet weight specifications. Belgian driver Jerome D'Ambrosio is instead declared the victor. Plenty of thrills and excitement to satisfy fans, given a glimpse into the future from the world of motorsports. Frank Contreras, CCTV, Mexico City.